Everyone is talking about AI these days. ChatGPT, Copilot, Gemini, whatever. And everywhere you look, there's a fancy AI-powered chatbot that looks really impressive. As a developer, you might ask yourself, how can I build such a chatbot on my own? Is it complicated? In this video, we will build our own chatbot with .NET Aspire, and you will see that it is really easy to get started. Let's not waste any more time, let's go. I will start by creating a new .NET Aspire starter app. I will create it with Visual Studio, later I will work with Writer. I will use the default settings and create the project. Let's switch to Writer and quickly launch the application. We see the typical Aspire sample application with the dashboard, the Weather API service and the Blazor frontend. Great, this is our base to start with. For our chatbot, we need a couple of NuGet packages. In the app host project, we will add the package community toolkit Aspire hosting Ollama. In the Blazor project, we will need the package community toolkit Aspire Ollama sharp. Now we can go to the program CS of the app host project and add a few lines. First, we need to add Ollama by calling the add Ollama extension method and give it a name. And we will also add a data volume so that the model used will be cached. Next, we need to add a model to the Ollama container we just created. There are several ways to do this. I will use the add Hugging Face model extension method to use a model from Hugging Face. Here we first need to specify a name for the resource and then the name of the model we want to use. Then we just need to do one more thing in this file. We have to call with reference and specify the Llama model so that the frontend project now has a reference to the Llama model. Now we can go to the program CS file of the Blazor project. Here we only need to add one line. We call the add Ollama sharp chat client extension method and specify the name of the Llama model resource we specified earlier, which is simply Llama. Thanks to service discovery, this is all we have to do. Next, I create a new Blazor component in the pages folder, a page to be exact, and I also create a CSS file. Now we have a new page that is available under this root, so we adapt the left menu to be able to reach the page. We can do this in the navmenu.razor file. I will just copy the weather entry and adjust values. That will do for this example. Now we can customize the chat page. First, I add the basic framework for the chat UI, a div for the container, a header, a div for the messages, and the controls for user input. Of course, we also want this to look nice, so I add some styling to the component CSS file. I have already prepared the styles, so I will just paste the CSS code here. Now let's write some code. First, I create a new class that represents a message, so it has a message text property and a type property, which is an enum that can be either sent or received. Then back in the chat.razor file, I create a list of messages which is empty at the beginning, then I create a string variable that I will bind to the input field that stores the user's text input. When the user clicks the send button, I want to execute some code, so I create a click handler for that. Here, make sure that the user has entered the message. As a first step, I simply add a new message to the message list and clear the input field. Then I go to the div that contains the chat messages. With for each loop, I go through all messages and render a div with the text of the message for each one. For proper styling, I distinguish between received and sent messages. Let's try out what we just created. I can type a message in the input field, and when I click the send button, the message is rendered in the message container. Great. Now it is time to add the AI magic. First, we need to inject an instance of the iChat client interface into the component. Now we can extend the send method. Here I create a list of chat messages that can be found in the Microsoft extension's AI namespace. I loop through the list of messages we used before. For each entry, I create the chat message object with the message text and the correct role and add it to the new list. This list is then sent to the complete async method of the chat client we injected earlier. The result of this method is the response from the chat client. So we'll add the message body to our list of messages, now with the message type received. Let's try this again. I type a message and press send. Then we have to wait a bit and there is the reply. We have just created an AI agent. I think this is really great considering how little code we had to write. For a better user experience, let's give the user a hand while we wait for the chat client to respond. To implement this, I create the bool variable in the component. At the beginning of the send method, I set the variable to true. When we get a response from the chat client, we set it back to false. And if the variable is true, we just render another message div with the text thinking, something like that. Additionally, I disable the input field while the chatbot is thinking, so the user cannot add another message in the meantime. With this change, we can send a message to our chatbot, and while we are waiting for the response, we can see the chatbot is busy thinking and creating an answer. Okay, that's it. What do you think? Wasn't that really easy? Of course, the chatbot's answers depend heavily on the model you choose, and some of the answers from the model I chose were quite questionable. But all in all, I am really impressed. Well, that's it for this video. If you're interested in how to send requests to a web API from Blazor component, watch this video next. Thanks for watching. Bye.